Hey guys, it is Monday, April 20th at 2:46 in the afternoon, and I am doing something that at least for a year and a half I've been saying I'm going to do, and I finally did it. Behind my house are some power lines, and all along the power lines there's a bunch of biking trails, and this right here is my favorite spot. You see people made some like rock foundations. Right, the woods behind me, right? It was a big old cliff I'm sitting on, or ridge. Right, and that's the gunpowder, which over that way turns into the Lock Raven Reservoir. And this is just a cool spot that I've never actually seen another person when I've been out here. And I just wanted to come out here and reflect and share with you guys. It was at this time of year, 8 years ago, in 2012, where a group of us was doing a Tough Mudder. The Gardeners and the Gutlers and the Knoxes and the Rabs. And, you know, a bigger guy, one of the questions was, man, you're like killing these training runs. Like, what are you doing that we're not doing? And, hey, let me tell you about CrossFit. And, you know, in my mind was already very much making financial models and kind of building on how I was going to start this gym. And then it turned into an outside group. And then that fall signed a lease. And 8 years later, here we are. And as I kind of sit here in a still moment with my buddy Chipper, the overwhelming sense of the whole thing is a sense of gratitude. Greg Glassman, he's the founder of CrossFit, and he describes himself as the leader of a biker gang, a loose affiliation that is the CrossFit movement. He says he's the caboose of the train. He is the match that then started a forest fire, right? Where I feel like that's a good representation of what I feel like as being the leader of outsiders, where it's this movement that years and years and years ago was way beyond me or anything that I was doing. But the belief in the common belief that suffering together makes us better, and that things are possible as a group that are not possible alone. And as we sit here in the middle of lockdown and social distancing, quarantine, however you want to describe it, that is so true, that we were designed by our Creator to live in community, and that we cannot do things alone by ourselves, right? Sitting home right now, think of the power. Right, laying on the ground sweaty after a workout, and to smile at someone and give them a fist pump and say, man, great job, that was a great workout, right? That is a powerful thing that we're longing for. And through all the people that I have gotten the pleasure to work with and befriend and go through this 8 years, there's just an overwhelming sense of gratitude, especially the crew right now, where I think this time in our life, it's like, hey, what is valuable? What is important? What do I care about? And what can I get rid of? I think that's what this thing is going to mean for all of us. And the fact that so many people are able and willing and to continue to be a part of this outsiders thing. Quite frankly, quite honestly, without that, pretty quickly, the outsiders wouldn't exist. But I really know that this is a refining, right? So, you know, we're getting, we're in the furnace right now, and, all of those impurities are getting, dripped away, and we're going to come out of this, man. I can't wait to see what is in store for the outsiders in the weeks, months, and years to come. And I just want you guys to know what's on my heart, and that it has been an honor and is an honor and really feels like what I was made to do. And I'm just so thankful for you guys. I just want you guys to know that. All right, guys. Make it a great day.